गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आर मैथ्स क्लास. माई सेल्फ मिसेज शगुफ्ता शेख इज अगेन बैक विद आर लेसन नंबर 6, डिवीजन पार्ट 1. इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन हाउ द डिवीजन कैन बी डन बाय अरेंजिंग द नंबर्स वर्टिकली, एंड नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आर लेसन. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट नाउ. स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैड सीन how division can be done by arranging the numbers vertically. Today we will see dividing 0 by a non-zero number. It means if we divide 0 by a non-zero number, what will happen? Let us see this through an example. Bharat, Sarla and Julie stood near a guava tree. This is a guava tree and these are the three children's name: Julie, Sarla and Bharat. So Bharat said, this is Bharat, and he is saying, I will put a bag around my neck and climb up to get the ripe guavas and let us share them. What he is telling? I will climb up to the tree and get the ripe guavas. The guavas which we will get, we will share among the three. So he climbed up the tree and Julie and Sarla waited below the tree. As they were waiting down, what the Julie said? Julie says, if Bharat picks 6 guavas, we will get 2 each. Means what she is telling? If he brings 6 guavas and if we distribute among the 3, we will get 2 each. 3 children are there. So 2 plus 2 plus 2 is how much? 6. We will get 2 each. Then Sarla says, if he get 10, we will get 3 each and there will be 1 left. Let's give him that 1. What the Sarla is telling here? If he brings 10 guavas, we will get how much? 3. 3 each. 3 plus 3 plus 3 is how many? 9. And 10 minus 9 is how much? 1. 1 will be remaining. So Sarla is telling that 1 we will give it to Bharat only. After some time, the Bharat climbs down the tree. He looks very disappointed. So Julie asks him, how many guavas did you pick? She is asking to Bharat, how many guavas did you pick? Bharat answers, there wasn't a single guava ripe. There wasn't any guava ripe. So Sarla says, since you picked 0 guavas, we will get 0 guavas each. What the Sarla is telling here? You have not brought any guavas, means 0 guavas. So we will get how many? 0 guavas each. If he hasn't brought anything, any guava, so we will not get any guava. From this, what do you understand? It means that 0 divided by 3 is 0. He hasn't brought any guava. And if that 0 guava we divide among the 3, how many each one will get? 0. That means 0 divided by 3 is 0. From this, what do we understand? When 0 is divided by any other number, that is by any non-zero number, the quotient is always 0. Have you all understood till here? Let us see next example. If there are 0 laddus on a plate, no matter how many children there are, each child will get 0 laddus. What they are telling here? Here is a plate and in the plate there are 0 laddus. Can you see any laddu over here? There is no laddu. So they are telling, no matter how many children there are, each child will get how many? 0 laddus. If there is no laddu in the plate, the children will get nothing. That means 0 laddus. If we divide 0 by 9. What we will get? 0 divided by 9. In the quotient place, we will write 0 and subtract 0 from 0. Answer is, the remainder will be 0. In the same way, if we divide any number by 0, the quotient will be always 0. Have you all understood? Now let us see the next example. Divide 80 divided by 4. Here we have to divide 80. 80 is the dividend and 4 is the divisor over here. We have to divide 80 by 4. So let us start from the tens place. This is units place, this is tens place. 8 comes, does 8 comes in 4's table? How many times does it comes? 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So we will write 2 in the quotient place. 4 twos are is how much? 8. We will subtract 8 from 8. What after subtracting, what we will get answer here? 8 minus 8 is 0. What the remaining here? What is remaining here? 0. This 0 we will take down. Now again 0 and 0. Just now only we have learned, if we divide 0 by number, the quotient is always 0. Therefore, what we will write in the quotient place? 0. 4 zeros is 0. Again we will subtract 0 from 0. The answer is 0. The remainder is 0. Have you all understood? If we read only 2 and if we don't put 0 over here, it would be wrong. What does this mean? 4 twos are 8. But here we have to divide 80. So 0 we have to put in the quotient place. First we divided 8 from the tens place. We started dividing. 4 twos is 8. We have subtracted 8 from 8. The answer here we have got is 0. This 0 we have taken down. And we have divided 0 by 4. If we divide 0 by 4 in the quotient place, what will come? 0. 0 minus 0 is how much? 0. Therefore, what is the quotient here? 20, and the remainder is 0. Have you all understood? Let us start with the exercise. Now let us start with the exercise on page number 38 of your textbook. This is the first sum. 50 divided by 5. Here we have to divide 50 by 5. What is the dividend here? 50, divisor is 5. So we will start from the tens place. What is in the tens place? 5. How many times does 5 goes in 5's table? 5 ones are is 5. So 5 minus 5 is 0. What about this 0? This 0 will come down as it is. And 0 divided by 5. What will come in quotient place? 0. 0 divided by 5 is 0. 5 zeros are 0, and if we subtract, what the answer will come? 0. Therefore, what is the quotient here? This is the quotient and this is the remainder. What is the quotient here? 10. And what is the remainder? 0. Let us take the next sum. Third sum of your textbook, 60 divided by 3. Here we have to divide 60 by 3. 60 is the dividend and 3 is the divisor. We will start from the tens place. 6 is in the tens place. How many times does 6 goes in 3's table? 3 twos are is 6. 3 twos are 6. And if we subtract 6 from 6, the answer will be 0. The 0 we will take down here. And 0 divided by 3 is 0. If we divide 0 by 3, in the quotient place we have to write 0. And 0 will come down here. 0 minus 0 is 0. What is the quotient here? Quotient is 20 and remainder will be 0. Have you all understood? I hope you all might have understood till here. For your homework, you will do sums on page number 42 of your maths practice book. We will meet in our next video. Till then, learn the tables from 2 to 20. Kindly subscribe our channel to receive further notification. Thank you.